Rogaine foam for hairline. I know Rogaine foam is used for hair loss, but my hair transplant surgeon told me it doesn't work for the hairline. Is this correct?
Thank you for your question. You're asking about Rogaine foam or Regaine foam and its relevance in terms of helping frontal hairline hair loss. You state that your hair transplant surgeon states that it doesn't help with the frontal hairline, and you want to know if that's true. Well, I can certainly give you some guidance on how I counsel our patients regarding Rogaine, Regaine, or any other minoxidil derivative solution or foam in our practice. A little bit of background, I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years, and I'm the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers. And in reference to the restoration of existing hair without surgery, this is something that we have become very well known for. It's a non-surgical treatment that we are able to help 99% of men and women with genetic pattern hair loss. We treat people who come to us from all over the world. So to settle this question about the effectiveness of minoxidil, certainly the studies done regarding minoxidil have kind of emphasized that it does have appears to have greater benefit in the crown area, but for pattern loss affecting the crown. However, when you think about it, we actually don't fully understand the mechanism in how minoxidil works for hair loss. And we certainly have gotten feedback from some people saying that it did help them in their frontal hairline. Now, of course, there's going to be a lot of variability. You have to understand that genetic pattern loss does affect the entire scalp. It's expressed differently. Some people, it's more of a frontal recession. So the basis for your hair transplant doctor to say it doesn't really work is that for men who are losing hair from a frontal receding hairline, very often it recedes very quickly and they don't seem to benefit. Men who have a crown-focused hair loss pattern seem to diminish slower. They appear to maybe have a little bit more time and get benefit. So it really is on a case-by-case basis. In our practice, we've actually helped patients who come to us for hair regeneration treatment. And briefly, this is a technology we developed using acellular matrix, which is from a method for wound healing, combined with platelet-rich plasma, which is derived from your blood as a concentration of the wound healing factors. We use this and we do a series of injections in one session in the scalp to help people reactivate hair that's not been growing, which is what you're trying to do with the topical minoxidil. We are also able to stop progression of hair loss, which you cannot do with topical minoxidil. And we induce the shedding of thinning hair and the growth of thicker hair. So it's when patients come to us and have this treatment, they'll often ask us, should they still use minoxidil? And generally we tell them no. After about a month or so, if they've been doing it for a long time, we say, you don't have to use minoxidil anymore because your hair is no longer thinning. So this is a very big deal when it comes to the different options there is for hair loss treatment. So I think that in a situation you're in, of course, this is in the absence of any photos, I doubt if there's any harm in using the Rogaine to see if you get any reactivation or benefit. But it might be your hair transplant surgeon's point is that you're better off getting a hair transplant, because if there's not much hair there, it's not going to make much of a difference anyway. So that being said, just I think you have to kind of get a sense of really what's your trajectory. We've been doing hair transplants for decades, and frankly, one of the most frustrating things about hair transplant is not being able to keep up with someone's progression of hair loss. Hair regeneration has helped us change that whole narrative and change the story. basically, if a person comes to us, even if they're a good candidate for transplant, we first recommend hair regeneration because we want to stop the progression. You can be using minoxidil, and even if you are responsive, it's not going to stop progression, and you can still continue to lose hair. The same does apply also to finasteride. Finasteride can slow it down considerably, but at the same time, it doesn't stop progression. That being said, have this discussion with your hair transplant doctor. A lot of times, the hair transplant specialists tend not to manage people long-term for hair loss. They tend to be more about the individual surgical procedure where the patient comes for needing a transplant, they get a transplant, they get managed postoperatively, and then they don't see the patient again until they have another transplant. So I think a lot of times the transplant doctors don't have as much day-to-day management experience when it comes to these types of issues because they focus on surgery. So again, from my perspective, there's no harm. You can certainly do it, but I think it's also an opportunity for you to maybe learn a little about the technology of hair regeneration, but understand all of this in the context of your pattern and your progression. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.